So hello and greetings to the all the viewers. Today we are going to talk about finite element thermal analysis of plate, that is also called as a conduction heat transfer analysis using ANSYS workbench. So in this video or in this presentation we will try to learn thermal conduction analysis of a rectangular plate, okay, and we will try to validate that using analytical calculations. Then we will start now. So this slide represents the learnings in this video. First we will go through the small introduction to the conduction, and then we will discuss about Fourier's law, and then we will discuss about thermal resistance, and then we will move towards our actual problem definition of a rectangular steel plate simulation. And then we will do the FEA simulation using ANSYS, and then we will calculate that the reactions, and we will try to validate with the analytical calculations. Okay. So now this slide represents the small introduction to the conduction phenomena. All of us know that the conduction is a mechanism of a heat transfer whereby energy is transported between parts of solid continuum by the transfer of kinetic energy between the particles or a group of particles at the atomic level. So the conduction is nothing but your internal energy exchange from one body to the another body, which is in perfect contact with each other. The thermal conductivity is the property of a material to conduct heat and evaluated primarily in terms of Fourier's law of heat conduction. So basically conduction is nothing but transfer of heat from one body to another body which are in perfect contact. So basically heat is transferred from high temperature to low temperature. So basically when we talk about conduction, so it is nothing but the solid parts which come into picture. When we talk about convection, then I think the fluid and your solid will come into picture. When we talk about radiation, I think that is also the third phenomenon of heat transfer. So here, as we discuss the conduction and the thermal conductivity, the Fourier law generates or the Fourier law governs that equation. So here the law of heat conduction, also known as a Fourier's law, states that the time rate of heat transfer through a material is proportional to the negative gradient in the temperature and to the area at right angle to that gradient through which heat flows. So here basically this is what you are the heat transfer through the material is directly proportional to the, or you can say the proportional to the negative gradient and to the area. So area we will discuss that in next slide, and here that is what your equation K minus dT by dx, where K is nothing but your local heat flux density, Q, K is nothing but your material conductivity, that is defined by watt per meter Kelvin. And your delta T is nothing but your temperature gradient, basically determined by dT by dx, and that is also K by M, right? So now the one more term which come into picture, that is thermal resistance. So when we talk about thermal resistance, is the heat property and a measurement of a temperature difference by which an object or a material resists a heat flow. It is also similar to the electric resistance. Okay, thermal resistance is the reciprocal of thermal conductance. Just an electric resistant is associated with the conduction of electricity, a thermal resistant may be associated with the conduction of heat. Then the Fourier's law of heat conduction for the wall can be expressed Q wall is equal to minus Ka T2 minus T1 divided by L. So basically this T2 minus T1 nothing but your heat transfer from your atmospheric to your that surface body temperature, and this R TH conduction is nothing but your thermal resistance. So if you see here, this is the thermal conductive resistance, in this case R, this one L divided by KL upon A. So L is nothing but your length, A is nothing but your area, and KL is nothing but your thermal conductivity. Okay, so you should remember this formula when you will going to do the calculate and the heat flux, okay, and then we will try to validate that using FEA simulations. So this slide represents our actual problem definition. So in this case, we will try to do the simulation. We will try to carry out the thermal conduction finite element analysis of a steel plate section and to validate with respect to analytical calculation. So here you can see this is what your rectangular plate having an area of 1 meter square, length of 25 meter and the thermal conductivity of steel as we know that 60.5 watt per meter Kelvin. Okay, and here you can see one side is having a temperature of 22 degree centigrade while the other side is having a temperature of 100 degree centigrade. So we will try to simulate this in using ANSYS and then we will do calculation and we will try to validate this. So this is simple the conduction phenomena. You can use this simulation for your actual practical simulations or actual practical cases. Okay, the methodology is same for a small as well as for a larger problem. Okay, then what we'll do, we'll move towards our actual FEA simulation part and then we'll do this steel plate thermal analysis. So now we are at our actual ANSYS deck video. So this is what you can just drag and drop your respective. So here it is static structural. I want that steady state thermal. So you just drag and drop steady state thermal and then you can open your design modeler to model that steel plate. These are my previously solved modules. So it will take some time to open that. I will close this, that is not needed. Okay. So here you can find a unit system over here. So you can use like metric, your SI units, or even you can go with customary or engineering as per your preference. So I will use this metric units. I will double click on this so that my design modeler will going to open. So it is already open. So we will try to see that, right? So from here, we can model a standard cross section, that is rectangular cross sections. So before that, if you want, you can further cross check cross section rectangular. So what I will do, I will keep 1 meter length, 1 meter height, okay, and I will try to extrude that by using 0.25 meter and generate. So if you see here, our body looks like this. We will try to measure the dimensions from this. So 0.25, this is 1, 1. And in our problem definition, the surface area is will be 1 meter square, okay, right? And thickness is 0.25. So we will try to use this model to perform the conduction analysis. So right now I will open my mechanical window. So it will take some time. So our model is open now in mechanical. So if you want, I will just show you the material details. So by default the structural steel is available, so you can use this material defense. And here you can see this 60.5, the thermal conductivity, right? So these are the two details which are needed for the simulations. And I will use by default mesh to generate the mesh. So you can say this is quite good mesh. And now we will try to simulate that conduction phenomena. So here the reference temperature is 22. And here I will use insert temperature. I will keep it as 22 as it is. And this side I will use temperature as 100 degree centigrade, right? So from this side it is 22, from this side it is 100, and now we'll try to solve this. It will not take time as it is quite simpler case. So we'll see the thick temperature gradient in the direction of this thickness, so I will use this thermal temperature velvet outer results. So you can find over here the temperature is varying from 22 to 100, and if you just wanted to see, I will just animate how the gradient is flowing. So you can see here, like temperature is varying. I will keep like 10 seconds so that you can see. See, from 100 to 22. Right? Now, what we'll do? We will try to see the reactions. So you just drag and drop over here, and you can see the reaction probe. So if you see here 18876, and here also 18876, that is what your the heat flux, or you can say the heat transfer, that is 18876 Wa. So what we'll do, we'll go to our actual problem definitions, and we'll try to see, say here 22 and 125. So now I will open Excel. I had already solved this, calculated, but in front of you I will further calculate the thickness of a plate. Plate is 0.25 meter, right? And area of plate is 1 meter square, right? This is what our thermal conductivity, then temperature gradient is equal to 100 minus 22, right? So degree centigrade. Now we'll try to calculate the heat flux rate. So that is basically, if you go to our Q wall, so this is nothing but your the thermal resistance reciprocal of thermal conductance. So you can see this is what your reciprocal of this thermal conductance. But what we'll do, instead of splitting these things, we'll directly use this equation. Minus K is the thermal conductivity, A is area, T2 minus T1 divided by L. Okay, L is nothing but your length. And if you go to previous slide, so here you can see here minus K delta T, and in that, as we wanted to see, across the thickness of a wall, so there you can put over area, and that this Ka T2 minus T1 L. Okay, so we'll use this equation. So here Q is equal to thermal, I will keep minus K into area into T2 minus T1 divided by length, right? This is your watt, and we will try to see in our FEA 18876, first one 18876, second. So if you see here, so both are now matching with FEA. So this is just cross check, there is no need to do this one. If you are doing proper way, it will also came the right. So you can see here heat flux rate analytical and as well as from FEA analysis. So it means that whatever the simulations we had performed, that is right one. Okay, so this is the simple phenomena of a simple steam plate. You can use this in pressure vessel case where you will find the conduction summation. In next video, we will try to do the convection, and then we will do the combined conduction plus convection. So this is what here the heat transfer is going to be done by using thermal conductivity of the steel. So here you can find the temperature gradient, that is nothing but the cause of solid thermal conductivity of this existing material. Suppose if you are using plastic, you will find the less gradient because plastic have a less thermal conductivity, right? So here you will find more K values, and here there are different this heat flow perfectly insulated, and this internal heat generation and heat flux, these are the loading condition. I think we had already discussed that in previous thermal simulations. So in this video, I just wanted to explain you this conduction phenomenon, that is quite simpler one, but here this is what you can validate. Okay, so that's it from my side. Let me know your comments. I will be there to help you. Thank you. Thank you once again. Bye bye. Take care.